Hey, everybody.
Hey, everybody.
I'm Dan. This is my beautiful wife.
So, day 13 countdown before the big transition to nomad life, living into this. So part of that has been giving away and letting go and selling a lot of our belongings. And, you know, we call it the 10,000 things.
It's the Tao. You know, right. If you're familiar with the Tao, Lao Tzu talks about the 10,000 things.
Yeah. And so it's been a really interesting journey because it's like when we let go of things, sometimes it feels like this great release. And other times it's like they're grasping at us and they're like, no, I'm not letting you, letting me go. And the emotions are up and down. Anyway, it's been like super interesting. It's like a roller coaster. We were talking the other day. And it was funny because there were things that we were about to let go or sell the car and sell the bike and all that. And it was like, once we were ready to do it and actually posted the things, then the car broke down, then the bike had a flat tire. And it was like, I said, this is like the egos or the 10,000 things. Second line of defense. Second line. First line, it's like the ego will tell you that it's so important, you must hold on to it. And then once you're okay, I'm going to release and let it go, then it's like second line of defense. It's like, we're not going to let you.
It breaks down or something. It breaks clinging on to us.
Yeah, really interesting. Anyway, so part of it has been letting go of all our clothes. We had been trimming down for a couple of years now because we've moved a lot. And we're kind of down to our essentials, the things that we had love for.
Yeah, the stuff that we thought we could never do without.
Yeah.
That we could never get rid of.
Yeah. And a few days ago, so there was like this 50 things of shirts and blouses and things I needed to give away. And I went to a consignment store because, of course, we're hoping to make a little bit of money out of all this to help us along and, you know, pay for something like a tank of gas or something.
At least.
So I went to the consignment store and brought everything in, had an appointment, that's how they work, early in the morning before the store opens, and brought everything in, and then the buyer came out. And she was like, I was trying to tell her about what we're going through and our experience and asking her, well, do you have an idea? Like, how do you think? So anyway, there was no connection. It was cold. It was robotic. There was like nothing to break through her coldness.
Strictly transactional.
Yeah. And Dan and I, when we started doing all this, we told ourselves, kind of committed to ourselves, that everything we do, it has to be infused with love. Mm-hmm. And from both sides, it has to be given, receive. And that's our guiding principle because we're taking this huge leap of faith. And anyway, so I ended up, after like being inside with her for 20 minutes, I was struggling inside like, Annie, you can't, now she's given you her time. I was feeling like I can't take my things away, but it doesn't feel right. And I had this big struggle inside. And at some point I just kind of got the courage and determination to tell her, you know what, this doesn't feel like what we want it to feel, so I'm going to take all my things back and go. And I did that. And that was just the doing of that, like affirming my truth, was so powerful. But then the gifts came yesterday out of that. Mm-hmm. Because what I did is I posted on a local network here where we live, saying I had all these things to donate or to sell. Did anybody have any suggestion? And someone replied and gave me the name of a woman who is helping Ukrainian families who are coming here as refugees to establish themselves. And we got in touch and she came here yesterday and she looked at everything we had. She took everything and more, anything we offered. And she was grateful and she was saying like, there's two 15-year-old girls, they're really fashion conscious, they're gonna love wearing this and dance clothes and shoes and everything. People are gonna be so happy, it's Ukrainians family with young girls and all my clothes, they're really into fashion. So all my good clothes that I'm giving away are actually gonna go to people who are gonna appreciate it. My sewing box and some fabric. She said, oh, we have a seamstress that came. So it's like exciting. And there was so much love. And it filled us up with joy. And it was like, oh, this is what it's supposed to feel like to, you know, there's the Marie Kondo stuff, you know, like only keep the things that give you joy. And I'll add, like, only give things away that bring joy to people also. And it was just like, wow, it was worth so much more than whatever money I could have gotten for those clothes in a consignment store with no relation to, no connection to the people that were going to have it. So that was a big, great gift in the middle of this craziness of exhaustion and scary and excited and all that. So I said everything. I don't know if you have something to add. Sorry, baby.
I don't know. No, it's good, honey. It's all good. It's, you know, it just kind of reinforced that. Like I said, it's not, it's when you do something out of love, when it's in the vibration of love, and you attract more of that vibration of love. So if you're conscious and you're aware of doing things in that vibration, then it's just, it's the flow. You get in the flow of love. And it's, I would much rather always, and you know this about me, I would much rather give everything away in the spirit of love than, you know, than get $5 from somebody who doesn't, you know, who doesn't care, you know.
Even, that even no sometimes, connection. Like, instead of getting $300, Dan would prefer to give it away. Because it's like, sometimes I'm like, well, no, come on, honey, we need money. But you love to give because of that feeling. And
And even the selling of these things, you know, our selling our Subaru and selling my motorcycle and stuff, it was done, the intention was to do it in the vibration of love. And that's who showed up to buy these things.
Yeah, it was magical. Connections, like stories from the same little village back east. And just all kinds of connection. Like, they were saying, like, are you kidding me?
Yeah. So, and it's a guy that loves that bike as much as I did. And he's looking through all the little details and, oh, I'm going to do this. And genuinely, you know, it's it isn't superficial. You could tell that it's genuine, genuine in the vibration of love, and it's that's important to us. So that's,
and as we move into this, like, as you come to learn our story, this is like kind of an unexpected way to be doing this with Dan's stage 4 cancer and being evicted from our house and choosing to do this way, not in the big fancy way that we wanted to do it. But it's like, this is why also we're doing it. We want to know what life is going to be like when everything is guided by love, and to have to be detached from as many things as we can.
It's a great meme that just floated through on Facebook again. It's attached to nothing, connected to everything. And that's how we want to live our lives. It's what we aspire to.
So that's it.
There it is.
That's the update for day 13 before Nomad Life.
And counting.
Okay.
So, see you, folks. Love you.